Oscar-nominated actor Paul Mescal brings to life a visual spectacle and intense character study in Gladiator 2. Yong Chavez returns with this story.
Filmmaker Ridley Scott has a knack for creating masterpieces that stand the test of time. But even he admits that returning to the world of Gladiator came with unique challenges.
And so it became part of people's lives, which I noticed that because it kept getting told 10 years later. And it's great that a film takes off like that, that has been created and you're being part of the creation. It's wonderful. And so then it becomes important to you to find the next one to do.
To bring that next chapter to life, Scott knew he needed the right talent to embody the central character.
I noticed this show called Normal People. He's fed up hearing this.
Yes.
I've actually won 8 hours of Normal People. Who the hell's that? That was the beginning. That was it.
Oh,
that's pretty cool to hear. I'm not really getting bored of hearing that, to be honest.
For Paul Mescal, stepping into the shoes of Lucius meant more than just performance. It was a turning point in his career.
In what ways do you think playing this role has made you grow even more as an actor?
The main aspect of growth would have been with responsibility. My first time in a studio picture, but my first time leading a studio film. So that's a big junction in any actor's career, and then to work with somebody who has the experience that Ridley has, because he's been there, done that, seen that with actors who are at this moment in their careers. And then I think he reduced it back down to me for the work. Like, I couldn't really focus on the fact that it was a big studio picture. Yeah. It was just we were working on the day that was out in front of us.
Mescal also dug deep into the psychology of his character, bringing a layered intensity to Lucius's journey.
I think people who are angry are normally very hurt. So people talk about the rage and the anger. But for me, it was about unpacking what is the hurt that is making him appear like such a dog, such fury. And it's ultimately tied to what the Roman Empire is to him, and ultimately what his relationship and how he feels neglected by his mother. So all of those things are very, very playable, and you try and condense it down so all of these big things like destiny and all, that they feel playable to an actor.
Scott's directing style played a crucial role in helping the actor find his footing.
You continue to set benchmarks in cinema. What was there any part of this that felt like uncharted territory for you?
Always, everything. I like being on thin ice. I like looking at uncharted territory. Everything is a learning curve, and it's about learning.
Gladiator 2 is now out in U.S. theaters and will premiere in the Philippines on December 4. Yong Chavez, ABS-CBN News, here in Hollywood.
In entertainment, the cast and crew of the new comedy series Interior Chinatown carve out stories of representation both on and off screen. ABS-CBN Hollywood correspondent Yong Chavez has the story.
In Chinatown, nothing ever changes.
For the Interior Chinatown team, the new comedy series is a provocative, satirical exploration of stereotypes, identity, and what it means to belong. The cast, led by Jimmy O. Yang, Chloe Bennett, and Ronnie Chang, reveals the intense and personal journeys behind bringing these complex themes to life.
Internally, I have to do like a lot of work, right? But at the same time, it's a lot of things that I've experienced myself, whether it's like an invisible ceiling, whether it's like he often felt like he didn't fit in. There is a line in the second episode where someone literally told him, you don't belong here, you know, and he has internalized so much of that.
I don't know what's going on.
For Yang, even the physical demands of the role challenged preconceptions, both his own and the audience's.
I've never done martial arts. And I think as an Asian actor or like as an Asian person, a lot of times people would expect you like you know martial arts, but I've never done any of it. So I had to like really train for like 3 months to be somewhat decent at it. And I ended up doing all my fight scenes and stuff. So that was really, that was pretty cool.
Pretend to take my order.
For Chloe Bennett, the satirical nature of the show provided a much needed outlet to process frustrations about her own experiences in Hollywood.
I almost therapeutically needed to have this satirical outlet because it feels maddening otherwise. And the show is entirely laced with my own real life frustrations or the confusion you can find yourself in when someone else, you know, kind of assumes something of you.
Waiters.
Yeah.
Ronnie Chang sees the show as a unique opportunity to tackle not just stereotypes, but also the industry that perpetuates them.
And it's
an ambitious project that says a lot socially. The scale of it is really cool, and it's a very meta story that's commenting on television and show business itself. Can't believe we got a chance to make it. May we all be so lucky to be a part of something so ambitious and well-written.
Beneath the humor and action, Interior Chinatown delivers a powerful message about how we categorize people and ourselves. The show is based on Charles Yu's award-winning book of the same name.
I think anyone, even if you're not Asian American, can understand and relate to the idea that there are all of these ways that we are subconsciously told how to value ourselves. A blunt takeaway is I hope that like an average white guy will be able to like watch it and like hopefully just be so, let the world wash over him in such an entertaining way that he could maybe see himself.
From humble beginnings in the audition room to leading roles in a groundbreaking show, the cast's stories echo the journey of their characters, fighting to be seen and heard in a world that often tries to define them.
It was just trying to sneak in. Chinese teenager number one, you know, person in line. I felt like I had to fight for it. It took many years to now finally being able to be the lead on this. It shows that now there's a seat at the table.
Interior Chinatown, now out on Hulu and Disney Plus, features a mostly Asian cast and includes a guest role by film actress Meriden Angeles in one of the episodes. Yong Chavez, ABS-CBN News, here in Hollywood.
A bionic knee and ankle system wins big at a biotech competition and may soon help people with motor disabilities. Take a look.
This is Cybathon, a competition showing technology for those with motor disabilities. As he maneuvers across a balance beam, Andrea Modica is wearing one of this year's top winners, the Omnia. The bionic system consists of two motorized components, Unico, the knee, and Armonico, the ankle. Its makers say its unique composition helps its users feel a more natural walk while keeping them safe from falls. The Unico knee combines hydraulic and electric technology. The hydraulic system is used for level walking or descending. The electric technology helps its user during tasks like climbing stairs or standing from a seated position. Samuele Di Giuseppe is with the Italian Institute of Technology, the makers behind the Omnia.
This strategy allows for a more physiological walk, allowing the patient to feel safer and a reliable system during the everyday life activities.
The Armonico ankle features an innovative screw mechanism that reduces heel impact and prevents tripping. Di Giuseppe says the device is fully customizable for the user.
Thanks to the sensor present on this system, the prosthetic device is able to adapt itself during the walk, allowing for a smoother transition and reducing the risk of stumbling for the patient.
While at Cybathon, Modica put the Omnia to the test on a race course mimicking daily life activities. He completed 9 out of 10 tasks in under 3 minutes. Researchers are working on refining the Omnia prototype in the lab before bringing it to market.
Over in Ukraine, Kyiv falling into darkness following Russia's second big attack on Ukraine's energy infrastructure this month. Officials said 9 regions are suffering from damaged energy infrastructure facilities, warning of at least 12 hours of power interruption for some residents. Russian President Vladimir Putin said the strike had been Moscow's response to Ukraine's attack on Russian territory using America's missiles. Over 1 million people reportedly lost electricity in Ukraine in the immediate aftermath of the Russian strikes. Australia passes a law banning social media for children aged under 16. The law, expected to take effect in November 2025, sets some of the toughest social media controls in the world and will force platforms to take reasonable steps to ensure age verification protections are in place. After a parliamentary session that stretched late into the evening, the Senate voted to pass the law earlier approved by the House.
World-leading action to make sure social media companies meet their social responsibility. Social media is doing harm to our children. And today, as a direct result of our legislation passed through the Parliament yesterday, through the Senate and confirmed in the House today, parents can have a different discussion with their young ones, a different discussion that will result in better outcomes and less harm for young Australians. Platforms now have a social responsibility to ensure the safety of our kids is a priority for them.
Critics of the bill, however, called it weak and only gives a false sense of security.
It's also obvious that the people who have drafted and fought for the particular elements of this bill actually have no idea how young people engage with the internet. Yeah. Absolutely no idea. I mean, it's almost embarrassing. I mean, this is boomers trying to tell young people how the internet should work.
Social media is such a prevalent part in young people's lives and how people socialize and interact with each other and keep in contact and build relationships with each other. And with such like a clear-cut ban, I believe that it will only create a generation of young people who will be more technologically literate in bypassing these like walls and things that will be used to deter young people from using it by using fake ages and fake identification, and won't achieve the desired effects.
In separate submissions, Google and Meta say the ban should be delayed until government concludes its planned age verification trial. TikTok says the bill needs more consultation, while X argues the proposed law might hurt children's human rights. Cracks appear in the Israel-Hezbollah ceasefire, with both sides accusing each other of violating the deal aimed at halting over a year of fighting. Israel says its Air Force struck a facility used by Hezbollah to store mid-range rockets in southern Lebanon. Israel also says it opened fire on suspects with vehicles arriving at several areas in the southern zone, saying it was a breach of the truce. The Lebanese army later accused Israel of violating the deal several times on Wednesday and Thursday. The exchange of accusations highlights the fragility of the ceasefire, which was brokered by the U.S. and France. The truce lasts for 60 days in the hope of reaching a permanent cessation of hostilities.